You know, I'm glad that when the computer mouse was invented, it wasn't too big, because then they might have had to call it the computer rat. And that would have made this next story really creepy, because the mouse in it is crawling up your arm. Here's Adam Yamaguchi.
Okay, we all know what this is, but did you know that this is the newest version of the mouse? Only it's not called a mouse, it's called Mayo, a device that reads the movements of your arm muscles and using Bluetooth technology transmits your gesture commands into action on your computer screen, gaming device, or presentation. 25-year-old Stephen Lake is the innovator responsible for moving this mouse from your hand up to your elbow. I traveled to Kitchener, Ontario, near Toronto, the Silicon Valley of Canada, to visit Stephen at his company, Thalmic Labs.
Welcome to Thalmic Labs. This is where we've created the Mayo armband here. Under this one roof, we do all of the engineering behind Mayo. We build the sensors inside here that pick up your muscle activity. We design the manufacturing processes, the software, the applications, all of that. There's so many different parts that go into building a product like this.
So tell me a little bit about how this works.
So the Mayo armband picks up the electrical activity from the muscles in your forearm. So when I have this band on here and I make a different gesture, my brain sends signals down my nerve, the nerve innervates that muscle, and each pod here on the armband is picking up the electrical signals from the muscles in that part of your arm as they're activated.
What are some of the basic and universal controls that you've developed into this?
So the basic gestures built into Mayo from the muscle activity we see here would be making a fist, very simple, making a fist, opening your hand, spreading your fingers apart, waving to the right or to the left, or finally this unlock gesture we use of tapping your thumb to your pinky finger. The bottom graph there is called the pitch, so if I have my arm up and down, you're gonna see the sensor's picking up that information. If I go kind of to the left or right here, we pick up what's called the yaw information, and finally the roll, the very top graph there. And you can see the virtual Mayo on the screen, of course, rotating as well.
If you're a gamer, the Mayo is a game changer because it's small and sleek, immersing you in your game without having to wear a bulky head device or finding the sweet spot in front of a sensor.
We often see new technology will kind of make its way into gaming first and then spread into other areas.
You can play any game that's integrated with Mayo, allowing your movements and gestures to manipulate the game's controls. And if that wasn't enough...
No way, are we gonna be flying this with a Mayo?
Exactly, yeah. So I'm gonna use the Mayo to control the drone through the tablet here.
Wow.
It only takes a snap of your fingers to fire up a drone.
So when I wave out, it'll fly up. When I wave in, it'll fly down. I can actually grab control of it by making a fist and angling my fist in any direction. So if I roll my fist left, it'll bank left. If I pull my fist back, it'll bank backwards. If I drop my hand and don't make a fist, I can just have it hover. And when I snap my fingers...
You just landed it with a snap.
The Mayo is in the final stages of development, but I use this prototype to test my skills flying the drone, which takes some practice and finesse.
Okay, how do I stop it?
But I eventually got the hang of it.
Now wave in with your wrist. Let it go.
Wow. You guys keep going on with the show. I'm gonna be playing here for a while.